Here are the most amazing inventions available now. Number 10. Emily, Robotic Lifeguard. Check out the Emergency Integrated Lifesaving Lanyard, or known more simply as Emily. I guess everything has to be an acronym. This is basically a robotic lifeguard that has superpowers, or something very close to them anyway. This remote-controlled buoy can easily navigate strong currents and surfs at speeds of 22 miles per hour. In other words, way faster than even Michael Phelps. This allows the buoy to reach drowning swimmers faster without risking an additional human life. Made by a company called Hydronalix, Emily is armed with a lighting system for night rescues, a couple two-way radios, a video stream so lifeguards on the shore can monitor the rescue mission, a jet pump, and enough handles to rescue 8 people at a time. If nothing else, Emily might be proof that not all robots are evil and trying to take over the planet. Sometimes they just want to save us from drowning. Number 9. Thievax. Simply put, we've got to figure out a way to clean up the ocean. There are all kinds of pollution floating around in the ocean, which isn't exactly a great thing. Thankfully, some people figured out a way to help alleviate the problem. The innovation isn't quite out yet, but there are working prototypes out there, and I'd be surprised if it doesn't actually become reality. First of all, let's quickly examine just how bad this problem is. Scientists have speculated that by the year 2050, the ocean will have more trash than fish. What? The Seavax, a wind and solar-powered ship that can essentially act as a giant vacuum for all the plastic crap on the ocean floor, just might be part of the solution to this daunting problem. The sensors help detect trash, and sonar technology protects marine and bird life from getting caught in the 160-foot-long vessel. Its compacted cargo is then either collected at sea or returned to port for recycling. Bluebird Marine Systems, a company based in Sussex, England, provided their proof of concept in 2016, projecting that the Seavax will be able to treat close to 90 million liters of seawater each year. Let's hope that this innovative vessel is out sooner than later. Number 8. Language Translating App. Need to talk with someone who speaks a different language? There's an app for that. No, seriously, there is. Actually, there are quite a few. While you have stuff such as Google Translator that have been around for a while, newer apps for phones are even more convenient. Take Voice Translator for Android, for example. You can record a phrase and the app will translate it to a language of your selection. This might come in handy if you're traveling abroad and need to be able to learn a few foreign phrases. Or it might be helpful if you encounter a local and need to converse with them. There's also the iHandy for iPhone. This one is pretty straightforward. You type a word or phrase into one box, pick the language you want to translate it to, and voila! It makes translations for you. Like magic. Sort of. Anyway, this might sound pretty basic, but considering people used to need translators or spend years studying a foreign language, this is one of those inventions that we almost take for granted. I bet this would have been very useful when they were building the Tower of Babel. Number 7. The Knockout. Here's a really creative way to catch a buzz, in different ways. It's called the Knockout, and it's an interesting little device that turns your beer bottle into a working bong once you've finished your beverage. Equipped with a mouthpiece and valve that are placed inside the beer bottle, all you have to do is fit the mouthpiece snugly over the bottle, flip it upside down, suck on the mouthpiece, and it shoots beer down your mouth, pretty much like shotgunning a beer. You see, that little pipe that sticks out? What that does is it allows air into the bottle while the valve keeps it from escaping. Once you're done guzzling down the beer, you now have a bong. Fill the bottle halfway up with water, place a gram of whatever smokable substance you like inside the pipe, light it up, and boom, you've got a bong. So in a nutshell, the Knockout is a very efficient way to get a couple of buzzes going, and it's probably up there in useful things for a great party. Number 6. Bottle Loft. You know how sometimes you run out of room in your fridge? Maybe you stock up on a bunch of beer and can't fit it all in there. Well, that's why someone created the Bottle Loft. The Bottle Loft is a series of magnetic strips that allow bottles to stick to the top of the fridge and just kind of hang out, allowing them to stay cool while freeing up plenty of other space in the fridge. These things will make sure your beer won't just fall off in the middle of the night. The strips are made from super strong magnets and crazy strong tape, known as 3M VHB. which is also what they happen to use on the wing flaps of commercial planes. So, yeah, it can handle your unopened beer, which will give you room to store something with some actual nutritional value or simply more beer. Your call. Number 5. Futuristic boards. As kids, we might have daydreamed about the distant future and imagined a world where people zoom around on hoverboards, like the Green Goblin, minus the hand grenades, hopefully. But we're not quite there yet. But we have made some serious advances towards that goal. Take the Z-Board 2, for instance. This bad boy is an electric-powered skateboard that reaches speeds of 20 miles per hour and has a range of anywhere from 16 to 24 miles. As the world's first weight-sensored electric skateboard, a rider can control the speed of the board by leaning forward or backward. Lean forward to go faster, or lean backward to stop. It's described by the makers as, quote, perfect for any trip that's too far to walk but too short to drive. Known for being lightweight and portable, the Z-boards could very well be the new way to make short commutes. And then there's the Flyboard Air, a hoverboard that allows you to totally fly over almost anything. Created by Zapata Racing, this hoverboard utilizes four turbo engines with 250 horsepower each. Powered by kerosene, it can be controlled using a remote throttle. In 2016, a video went viral of Frankie Zapata, the CEO of Zapata Racing, zooming around on the Flyboard Air. The Flyboard Air seems to be the most extreme hoverboard out there. Other companies, such as Lexus, have hoverboards, but it's still Zapata Racing that has made ones that really flies. But as Zapata himself pointed out, anyone brave enough to ride on the Flyboard Air should have experience with hoverboards, especially with the Flyboard Air's predecessor, the Flyboard, which is a hoverboard of sorts powered by water jets. Whether or not it takes off as a viable mode of transportation still remains to be seen. Number 4. Kymco Smart Scooters. You definitely know about smart cars and electric cars, which are definitely the future. But what about those who don't drive cars or want to be even more efficient? Smart scooters are making their presence known. A Taiwanese company called Kymco has started what they call the New Do Experience. Basically, they have created a new dashboard for scooters, which display info such as time, weather, a speedometer, and a simple compass to keep riders going in the right direction. All of this allows riders to stay informed while not taking their hands off the controls or their eyes off the road. It also connects to smartphones, so when the scooter is stopped, riders can see alerts on their dashboard. Riders can also customize their dashboard with color schemes, photos, and all kinds of interesting elements. The super cool thing is that riders can connect with their friends who are also part of the new Do system. So, let's say you're cruising around town or your scooter looking for your friend Bob. You know Bob is on his scooter as well. Thankfully, you're both on the new Do system, so Bob now appears as a blip on your dashboard. He's just a couple of blocks away. And now you can catch up with him quickly without having to pull over and call him. Or this is another useful way to stalk someone. Number 3. Germ-killing paint. In 2015, Sherwin-Williams came up with a plan to stop the spread of infections within hospitals. According to a story by CNN, around 1 in 25 people will contract some kind of infection or sickness while staying in hospitals. This leads to serious illness and sometimes death, which of course, pretty much sucks. But thanks to Paint Shield by Sherwin-Williams, that may be a thing of the past. Sherwin-Williams says that Paint Shield is unique because it doesn't just prevent the growth of common bugs, it also eliminates more than 99% of germs while killing common microbes in the process. That's thanks to the product's active ingredient, alkyl dimethyl benzyl ammonium chloride, or QAAT. EPA test protocols show that Paint Shield antibacterial capability can last up to 4 years as long as the surface integrity is preserved. Paint Shield is available in more than 500 colors and isn't limited just to hospitals. This stuff could be useful anywhere germs are common, such as walls of medical complexes, locker rooms, schools, and daycare centers. Number 2. Exoskeletons. Imagine a suit of armor that gives you increased strength and endurance while allowing you to stay limber. Well, the exoskeleton isn't a figment of the imagination, it's a real thing that's being used today. These wearable machines are powered by a series of motors and hydraulics to provide people wearing them greater strength, endurance, and protection. They have many practical uses, especially in the medical field, such as helping people without arms or legs and improving their quality of life. It may even help medical professionals improve precision during surgery or nurses to lift heavy patients or equipment. Perhaps unsurprisingly, exoskeletons can also be used in the military. Since they add strength and endurance without limiting mobility, soldiers can use them during missions while carrying heavy weapons or equipment. It might even be useful for other tasks, such as on construction sites where workers often have to lift heavy objects, or maybe even firefighters who have to work in dangerous environments. If exoskeletons seem cutting edge, because they are, but the idea goes all the way back to 1890 when a Russian dude named Nicholas Yagin designed an apparatus to assist with walking, running, and jumping. But that was pretty basic. These days, you have exoskeleton products such as ReWalk, which assists people with lower limb disabilities, or Sarcos products and their array of exoskeleton arms and legs that allow people to lift up to 200 pounds with basically no effort. And even Honda has developed exoskeleton legs that has a seat for the user. And that's just naming a few. Dozens of companies have created products featuring this amazing technology. Number 1. Bionic Eye. As unbelievable as it might sound, there is now a way to restore sight through a brain implant. Also known as the Bionic Eye or the retinal implant, the Argus 2 from Second Sight aims to help people suffering from vision loss. Here's how it works. A miniature video camera housed in the patient's glasses captures a scene. The video is sent to a small patient-worn computer, the video processing unit, where the video is processed and transformed into instructions that are sent back to the glasses via a cable. These instructions are transmitted wirelessly to an antenna in the retinal implant. The signals are then sent to an electrode array, which emits small pulses of electricity. These pulses bypass the damaged photoreceptors of the eye and stimulate the retina's remaining cells, which transmit the visual information along the optic nerve to the brain, creating the perception of patterns of light. Patients learn to interpret these visual patterns with their retinal implant. This basically allows you to see a visual representation of the world around you, which supplements your own sight. Now that's pretty impressive. Here's what's next. They've said that in the near future, they plan on cutting off the head of one body to transplant to another. Let's just let that sink in for a second. The doctor crazy enough to attempt such a surgery would be Italian neuroscientist Sergio Canavero and his sidekick, Chinese doctor Xiaoping Ren.